Thank you again for your time, Mr. Kogan, and thanks for your patience. Next.
Five-34 in progress. Five-30 in progress. Five-34 complete. Five-40 in progress. Five-30 complete. Thank you. 540 complete. Five thirty in progress. Five sixteen in progress.
Roger. 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 Roger.
Get on the ground.
We have visual. Roger. Roger. Roger.
On the ground.
Roger. 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 Roger.
Roger. Get on the ground.
Roger.
On the ground!
Roger. 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 Roger.
Roger. Roger.
Roger. Roger.
no Gina. Like a flight with no visa, first class with the seat back, I still see ya. In my past, you on the other side of the glass of my memories museum. I'm just saying, hey Mona Lisa, come home. You know you can't roam
as
without
I
Caesar.
Recall, I know you love to show off, but I never thought that you would take it this far. What do I know?
Team in progress.
Do you see him, Pedro? prom queen Sharon wants to fuck him, and even Susie the ballerina, who turned him down on 3 separate occasions because she didn't want to have anything to do with the fucking stutterer. Well, now Susie is showing off her pirouettes in his bedroom. And it's all thanks to you, Jack. All thanks to the fact that you couldn't stick to our simple arrangement and answer the fucking phone when I called.
I couldn't pick up the phone because at the moment when you called, the phone was literally being shot at. And then
You're one lucky bastard, Jack. I mean, you are lucky that I have such a cold, black heart, completely incapable of compassion, without batting an eyelid. I will leave that poor stutterer Chris with nothing. I'll make a couple of calls, and he'll turn right around on that road he's on to Sharpwood and return to his miserable life of the lonely loser. He's just not the right man for Tanya. I mean, some people just aren't made for each other, you know? True, you'll have to pay me twice as much.
Twice? 20,000? But I only
That's not the worst of it, Jack. You not only have to pay me twice as much, but you'll have to do it 4 times as often. 20,000 a week. I hope whatever mess you got yourself in, you still got all your fingers, or at least enough of them to pull out a bank transfer. How long until the next payment? Huh? 4 days?
Come on. Let's talk.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jack. I have another call. I'm guessing that Mr. Cervantes just finished eating his strawberries.
His what? Strawberries? Listen, Fry, I'm just asking you... Fuck.
544 in progress.
There's a walk line between red and green, between port and Chardonnay, just sitting, sipping pickling brine. Walk, my shoes fall off, my socks are wearing thin. These days I find the time to breathe.
I-44 complete. I-522 in progress. I-22 complete. 541 in progress.
No one else to see these days. I try and try to breathe deeply. My time away and lack forethought. Thought of my lead and what with the business.
I-41 complete. I-55 in progress. I-55 complete. I-526 in progress. 526, complete. Five 11 in progress. Five 11 complete.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm listening.
It's me.
I'm listening, Lily.
I decided that I wanted to talk about the woman.
What woman?
About the woman with the coins.
Lily, do you realize that you're calling me in the middle of the night?
It was wrong, Jack, what you did.
Everyone is sucking up on Spectrum 1. Spectrum Internet.
It's not the worst thing you could. I don't want to compare it with. I want to tell you that I think it was wrong, and I think that you yourself understand that it was wrong. Am I wrong?
Lily, go to sleep.
Jack, I want to... just want to make sure that we're seeing eye to eye on this. That we're on the same team, you know? It's important to me.
For a cop, nothing's more important than a good night's sleep. You can trust me on that.
It seems I'm more like a nanny than a cop.
And I'm all cop.
540 in progress. FM 22 in progress. FM 534 in progress. FM 522 complete. FM 519 in progress. FM 534 complete. FM 519 complete. FM 520 in progress. FM 520 complete.
God, Lana, you know how to sneak up on somebody.
You're seeing Plunkett today, right?
Only if I manage to rake up all this paperwork before noon. Talking to the old man after that is useless. He'll already be soaking up his cocktails. I hear they're having problems with the new curator from the mayor's office, the one in the green jacket.
I need to take notes on Isaac Brommel's testimony. You remember him, paralyzed at the waist. It's 3 hours one way. I'll be stuck there until evening. So I need you to give this folder to Plunkett. Mila says that he's leaving tomorrow, flying off on some conference. So I want him to get the folder today, okay?
What do you have?
I want the Jack Boyd case given special status.
Oh, Lana, do you even understand what special status even means?
I need access to the closed sections of the police department's archive. I need to be removed from all other cases. I need two assistants. I need support from Paulson.
Lana.
I need a surveillance team, a judicial order for
Lana.
The wiretapping of four witnesses. First of all, Emma Weinstein, and permission to
Lana,
search her.
Lana, listen to yourself. What are you trying to achieve? Do you even understand what's waiting for you? It's one thing to drag all the witnesses through here 10 times. Plunkett is somehow tolerating that. But it's another thing to... Oh, God, if you... Why don't you do something...
Something easier?
More relevant.
Have you looked at the papers recently, Reeves? No one's seen Jack Boyd for almost a year, and he's still on the front pages. Show me something more relevant.
Oh, Lana, look, God knows. You did what you could. The asshole is already 8 months on the federal wanted list. The feds can't find him. And you, I mean, can you? You mind-fucked all your colleagues, mind-fucked everybody, one by one, through the whole police department. Plus any poor son of a bitch who ever saw him, talked to him, delivered him pizza, or checked his prostate. You went through mountains of documents, some of which you were not supposed to see, and I have always been ready to look the other way. Until you come
in... You're not my boss, Reeves. I don't care if you looked the other way. I never asked you for help with the investigation, and I'm still not. Just give Plunkett the fucking folder and make sure he's sober enough to read it.
550 in progress. I-52 in progress. In progress. I-565 in progress. I-52 complete. I-542 in progress. I-519 complete. I-50 complete. I-553 in progress. I-542 complete. I-565 complete. I-534 in progress. I-553 in progress. I-553 complete. I-534 complete. 532 in progress. Complete. Five 52 in progress. Five 32 complete. Five 54 in progress. Five 54 complete.
Warren Nash.
It's me, Jack. I have a strange question for you. How would you say your work is going?
What are you talking about?
I mean, I don't mean in general, just today. The work you did today, are you pleased with what you did?
What kind of question is that?
I'm talking about...
I need to sleep, Lily.
Jack, I'm not trying to...
529 in progress. Five 69 in progress. Five 29 complete. Five 69 complete. Five 68 in progress. 570 in progress. F-534 in progress. F-534 complete. Thank you.
have visual. Roger. Roger. We have visual.
We have a visual. Thank you. 580. Thank you. 580.
Roger.
Roger. Roger.
Do you live here, old man?
Go home, Mr. Boyd.
Who am I talking to?
My name is Colonel Liam Henderson, but as you can see, we'll have to do this some other time.
How do you know my name?
I think there are only two of them, but best be safe. Check the area and tell Mark to shut off that engine. Someone will have to stand watch here until morning.
Hey, I'm talking to you.
Go home, Mr. Boyd. Lock the door. Stay away from the windows. Don't come out till morning. We'll talk another time.
Time for hot chocolate. Don't pay any attention to me. I'll evaporate in a second.
Who are you?
I'm Sean Moreno, secretary and dispatcher, office manager, sometimes even a plumber. I have a very wide range of responsibilities. It's easier to say what I don't do.
What, and delivering hot chocolate to the offices? Is that one of your duties?
No. Well, not usually. But I thought that this morning you might need a big mug of something warm. It's easy to catch cold from lying down in the snow at night. And we don't need you catching cold, right? Oh, that was one cold night. No, if you ask me, all nights are cold.
What are you talking about?
Here, hot chocolate with maple syrup, red pepper, and herbs. I should think I can manage to make this drink. You can't survive in Sharpwood without it. But I won't give you the exact recipe. Don't even ask. I didn't know what kind of cupcakes you like, so I brought a few. There's more chocolate in this one, less in this one, and there's no chocolate at all in this one. But there's little nuts. Very tasty, but they get stuck in your teeth, so be careful. Oh, yes, and your revolver. I cleaned it up. Shines like new. If you need any bullets for it, Mr. Boyd, just...
Who are you?
Like I said, Mr. Boyd, I have a wide range of responsibilities.
Secretary, dispatcher, manager, plumber, and Colonel Henderson's bitch? That about right, you fuck? That about it for your responsibilities? Think you can come into my office like that and call me Mr. Boyd, you fucking piece of shit?
There aren't any bullets in it, Mr. Boyd.
Oh, well, you want to see what I can do to you with a pistol with no ammo, you fuck? I'm a man of many talents, just like you.
I have no doubt, Mr. Boyd. Actually, I'm a big fan of your talents. You're a legend, Mr. Boyd. I look up to you.
What are you going on about, you dirtbag?
It's what you did in Freeburg. All your plans, the whole operation. The story about the antique weapons, the Japanese businessman's money, the park construction project. I can't pick a favorite. Well, it's probably that case with the DeVroom painting. Oh, that was top class. You're the only man who's ever turned corruption into art. If someone were making a film about you, Mr. Boyd, I would...
Listen to me carefully, secretary, dispatcher, manager, plumber. I don't know what you read here in the newspapers, and I've got no idea what your boss could be dreaming, but you got me wrong, okay? I was a scapegoat. I once let motherfuckers like you manipulate me, but I learned my lesson. So if you're gonna threaten me, you better just get it over with.
No one's threatening you, Mr. Boyd. It's quite the contrary. Now, once you get to know Colonel Henderson better, you'll see you have nothing to fear. Like I said, I appreciate your talents, and Colonel Henderson appreciates them too, believe me. Now, it's a lucky thing you arrived in Sharpwood when you did.
The key you used to open my office. Leave it and go.
you do know that I have copies, right? I could make 100 more.
I said leave the key and go. If I see you in my office again, you will drown in a mug of hot chocolate. I promise you that.
You have nothing to fear, Mr. Boyd. You're safe here.
I-76 in progress. I-16 in progress.
Thank you.
Hey, it's your dry skin. Help me stay hydrated and healthy looking all day.
Code I, 521 in progress. Five 76 complete. Five 16 complete. Five 69 in progress. Five 15 in progress. Five 15 complete. Thank you. 526 in progress. F-35 in progress.
Roger. We have visual.
Roger.
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 Thank you. Roger.
F-35 complete. 524 in progress. Code I. Code 518 in progress. Code 524 complete. 523 in progress. Code 518 complete. 524 in progress. Code 523 complete. Code 536 in progress. Code 524 complete. 536 complete.
I'd like to see Sheriff Lily Reed.
Why do you need Sheriff Reed, Mr.?
Carter. Captain Britt Carter. That's why the day when you, Captain Carter, step through the threshold of our department will not only be an important day for the whole of Sharpwood, but also a very happy day for me personally. Well, it seems I'm here to make Sheriff Reed very happy, son.
Hey, I told you to stay away from my office.
It looks like we've got a problem here.
And I need something that will help with these headaches. I get migraines, you know. Or is this a migraine or is it just a headache? It's not the same thing, you know. They're different things and they need different medicines. The cure for one is not the cure for the other, you know. And if something isn't curing you, it's killing you. The medicine for headaches won't help with migraines. Dr. Kanayan explained the difference to me, but
Okay, do you need an aspirin?
No. It's a different one.
Acetaminophen?
No. The one with the letter B.
Well, let's just write that down.
We need to talk. Now.
Excuse me, Mr. Nash, but right now I'm...
Hey, can't you see? There's a line.
What's going on here?
I just listened to the... needs of our townspeople every week. I try to help them get access to food and drugs that aren't easy to come by in Sharpwood. I don't want them going to the smugglers, you know?
Get back to the end of the line.
Quiet. I work here. Lily, there's a man
you
in...
You work here? Well, then, I'll tell you, boy, the floor in the corridor I walked across over there is the dirtiest floor I've ever seen in my life. And if my taxes are going to...
I'm not the janitor. I'm a cop.
A cop? Perfect. So you have to solve my problem with the rats.
I don't... Lily, listen. There's a man named Carter waiting for us in my office.
Carter? Wait, Captain Brick Carter?
Yes, that's him. Would you,
Tip. Write down all the medications Mr. Moses needs, then do the same for the others. Get everything down in detail... Oh, forget about your notebook. Take mine. Start a new page for each person. Got it?
There's still one thing I just can't understand, my dear. Why did you write me this letter? If you already have this...
Mr. Nash appeared out of... He appeared unexpectedly. He worked undercover for a while, and he was sent for by... This is an operation. It's all part of a big operation, some kind of big operation. I myself don't know all the details, but I think Mr. Nash himself can tell you everything he...
Oh, I have no doubt that Mr. Nash will tell us everything. He'll tell us how he was assigned to this operation. He'll tell us how he was sent his orders on a beautiful piece of paper with a seal and a signature. He'll tell us how he had to pack up everything in his big city apartment, and how carefully he packed his expensive trousers in his expensive suitcase. Oh, how he had to grow a beard to blend in. Yeah. He'll tell us all about his brilliant career. You must have been an excellent student at the academy, Mr. Nash. Well, perhaps you think you already know everything there is to know. But there's something you don't know, Mr. Nash. It's something very important. A city like Sharpwood can't be saved by some upstart careerists and bureaucrats from central administration. A city like Sharpwood can only be saved by its people. People who were born here, who grew up here. These are our demons, Mr. Nash, and we have to deal with them ourselves. You were sent here by the chiefs in the suits. while I, prodigal son of Sharpwood, was returned here by the Lord himself.
Oh, so in your opinion, Sharpwood will be saved by a lame soldier with no police experience holding his Bible at the ready.
I will not take offense to your disrespectful remarks, Mr. Nash, because I myself was once just a stupid fool. I did not understand that God saved me in the war. I did not understand that it was he who helped me survive after what happened to me after the war. But now I understand. Now I see. Now I am ready, and have no doubt, Mr. Nash, I have come not with a shield, but with a sword.
Well, then prove it. Work here for a week and show us what you can do.
All right, I already said we're not making this into a stupid game. Mr. Nash, you've done an excellent job, but you have to agree that this
Lily, isn't... this isn't a game.
This is a test, and it's a test that I humbly accept, my dear Lily. I have endured many. Pass them all with dignity, and I will endure this one, too.
Oh, of course. You'll love it.
Excellent. Just fine. Now we have two more stubborn boys in the department.